Depowering the sails.
Okay. What does that mean?
You're supposed to be in the Navy.
I don't sail boats, Teddy. I land on them.
To be able to shoot on the Teddy Roosevelt is some of the most incredible and challenging filming I've ever done.
That aircraft carrier was christened in 1986 when Top Gun came out by the Secretary of the Navy.
Sitting in that theater watching the original Top Gun and went, okay, I want to go fly Navy jets off Navy carriers, and that's what I'm going to go do.
Ready at 3, 2, 1.
We're on there for, I think in total, about 2 weeks. We were all bunked up together.
Getting to be in such close quarters with people, I think it brought everybody really close together.
It's a pretty crazy experience on the carrier. That is a warship. It's not a cruise.
We got to live as sailors live. We ate their food. We slept in the bunks. We actually watched them launch aircraft. We got to be right there on the flight line.
Being on that aircraft carrier when the F-18s are taking off. As an audience, you go, I want to be part of that world.
One of the things I didn't get to do on the first one was getting a cat shot on the carrier. I did on this. I'm getting catapulted off of the aircraft carrier.
No one's ever done that in a movie before. It's something that only naval aviators get to do.
Jerry Bruckheimer and I were made honorary naval aviators. We are part of the Navy, officially. There's only 35 people, I think, that are awarded that honor.
I'm very grateful to the Navy and to represent what it is to be a naval aviator.
You see people moving like a clock. Each one goes down, this one goes off, the next one moves forward. It's like an assembly line where there's no margin for error because there isn't.
How many people does it take to launch an F-18 off the carrier? 5,000. Because any one person on that boat is not doing their job. Ultimately, that system breaks down.
It's a ballet of machinery. To watch it in action, you're just in awe.
Do a we are TR, can we do that?
We are TR!